Hello, book friends. It's Allie, and today I am doing a genre chat. I'm going to talk about seven fantasy tropes and books that do them well. I'm going to start with found family / anti-hero, and that book would be The Lies of Loch Lomora by Scott Lynch. This book is incredible. I gave it 5 stars. It is about a boy named Loch Lomora, and he starts out as an orphan, and he gets accepted into this other group of thieves, and they all become very close-knit family, and they work together to pull off heists and to just generally cause mischief. And this book is really, really good. Once you get into it, it's nigh impossible to put down because it's just so fast-paced. But it really does those tropes very well. He is not a good guy by any means. Loch Lomora is a bad guy, but you root for him and you love him. This book is so good. The next trope is unlikely person thrown into a hero position / a hidden magical world / dimension. And that would be Neverwhere by Neil Gaiman. In this book, the main character is like living an ordinary life, and all of a sudden he gets thrown into a very weird circumstance that takes him into the London Underground and like a hidden world that he never knew about and that is so closely veiled with the world that we live in that you don't notice it until you're thrown into it. And then once you're thrown into it, it's almost impossible to get back out of. So it's his story as he like navigates this crazy world that he's been thrown into and gets sucked into this crazy kind of adventure. It's very good, very difficult to put down once you pick up. Also a 5-star book. The next trope I'm going to cover is the black and white good versus evil. So this is like the bare bones, good versus evil. You see it a lot, and The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis does it very well. You have the White Witch. She is bad. All of the people who work with her are bad. You have the good people who follow Aslan, the lion, and it's either one way or the other. You don't have a redeeming arc for the bad guy in this book. You don't have a backstory. You just have what is right in front of you, good versus evil. There is no more to the good guy or the bad guy. There is just that black and white dynamic. The next trope is hidden magical abilities. And that would be Howl's Moving Castle by Diana Wynne Jones. This story follows a girl named Sophie. She has a very plain, ordinary life, and she believes that since she's the third sister, that she is going to have, like, terrible luck in her life, and she's never going to have any kind of riches, and she's not going to have anything fancy. So she basically has settled into a comfortable life where she's just okay. And she gets kind of thrown into the middle of a very weird circumstance. I don't want to spoil it for you if you've never read it or seen the movie. So she gets thrown into a very weird circumstance, which causes her to leave home, and then she ends up living in this castle with the wizard Howl. And there are a lot of characters in this book, and I'm not going to tell you which character has hidden magical abilities, but this story does revolve around that, and there are hints all throughout of who it is and what's going on, and it also has a friends to lovers vibe in it. So if you kind of like that feeling, it's not the like dominant theme of it, but it does come into play in the end, and it's just so well done. This book is so incredible. If you haven't read it, do so. Or at least watch the movie. The movie is also very good. The next trope is a magic artifact, or like a hidden magic artifact, and that is The Thief Lord by Cornelia Funke. Cornelia Funke also wrote the Ink Heart, Ink Spell, and Ink Death trilogy. Those are also really good. but I don't know if a lot of people really know that she wrote this. This is an incredible book. I read this in one sitting because it, once you get into the story, it's so difficult to put down. It's just really, really good. It follows this little boy who is the thief lord, and he is stealing from the rich and giving to these children who are homeless and living in this theater. And then you have a detective who is trying to locate a missing boy, and all throughout you're not really sure, like, who he's looking for, if it is the thief lord that he's trying to track down. It all comes together in the end, and there is this hidden magic artifact that they're seeking throughout, and that plays a huge role in the story. And so this book is a whirlwind. It is so good. This is young adult fiction. Well, this is children's literature, and it is very, very well done. I highly recommend this book, and the trope is done very well in this one. The next trope is going to be a hidden love, or also high stakes magical game that plays in both of those play a role in this one, and that is the Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. And this book has, like the trope suggests, a high stakes magical game, and the way that Morgenstern does that in this book is so incredible. The circus and all of the magic that goes into the circus and all of the characters are so whimsical, and everything about this book is just so magical and whimsical, and it just makes you feel like you're absorbed into this scene of just beauty. Like, the circus really seems beautiful and wonderful, and this book is exciting and fun and just very well done if you like truly whimsical stories. The final trope that I'm going to talk about is the quest trope, and that's where the main hero goes on some kind of quest to achieve some goal, and that would be The Iron Ring by Lloyd Alexander. Tamar is a prince. He has a mysterious visitor in the middle of the night, and he gambles with this visitor and gambles his life into servitude. So he loses when he's playing, and the man tells him that he is to travel to his kingdom. So this story is all about Tamar honoring that bet that he made and traveling to the other man's kingdom. And it is about all the people he meets in between and the self-realization that he has along the way. And Lloyd Alexander is a superb writer. It's just, this book is falling apart. I think I've told you guys before, but like, this book is literally falling apart. I've read it so many times. It is a very, very good book. So if you enjoy the quest trope, the self-realization, the hero that makes a lot of new friends and gets into some trouble and is like just hard determined to hold on to a promise that he made to someone else, this book is for you, and it is 5 stars, and it is so good. That is all of the books that I have to share with you guys today. I hope that you have found something that maybe you'd be interested in or that you haven't seen before. So if you have read one of these books before, drop me a comment down below, let's chat about it. Or if you haven't read one before, I'll talk to you about it in the comments. Make sure to like, subscribe, do all the things that YouTube does, and I will see you guys next time.